Now let us see operating system services. Operating system services. List and explain the services provided by OS for the user and efficient operation of the system. An operating system provides an environment for the execution of programs. It provides certain services to programs and to users of those programs. See the figure. OS provides services for the users of the system, including user interface, means by which user can issue commands to the system depending on the operating system. These may be a command line interface, example SH, CSH, KSH, TCSH, etc. A graphical user interface, example Windows X, Windows GD, KDE, GNOME, etc. or a batch command system. In command line interface, commands are given to the system. In batch interface, commands and directives to control these commands are put in a file and then file is executed. In GUI systems, window with pointing devices to get inputs and keywords to enter the text. Program execution. The OS must be able to load a program into RAM, run the program and terminate the program either normally or abnormally. Input-output operations. The OS is responsible for transferring data to and from input-output devices including keyboard, terminals, printers and files. For specific devices, special functions are provided. Device drivers by OS. File system manipulation. Programs need to read and write files or directories. The services required to create or delete files, search for a file, list the contents of the file, and change the file permissions are provided by OS. Communications. Inter-process communications, IPC, either between processes running on the same processor or between processes running on separate processors or separate machines may be implemented by using the service of OS, like shared memory or message passing. Error detection. Both hardware and software errors must be detected and handled appropriately by the OS. Errors may occur in the CPU and memory hardware, such as power failure and memory error in input-output devices, such as a parity error on a tape, a connection failure on a network, or a lack of the paper in the printer and in the user program, such as an arithmetic overflow and attempt to access an illegal memory location. OS provides services for the efficient operation of the system, including resource allocation. Resources like CPU cycles, main memory, storage space and input-output devices may be allocated to multiple users and multiple jobs at the same time. Accounting. There are services in OS to keep track of system activity and resource usage, either for billing purposes or for statistical record keeping, that can be used to optimize future performance. Protection and security. The owners of information in file in multi-user or networked computer system may want to control the use of that information when several separate processes execute concurrently. One process should not interfere with other or with OS. Protection involves ensuring that all access to system resources is controlled. Security of the system from outsiders must also be done by means of a password. User operating system interface. There are several ways of users to interface with the operating system. Command line interface or command interpreter allows users to directly enter commands to be performed by the operating system. Graphical user interface allows users to interface with the operating system using pointers, device and menu system. Command interpreter. Command interpreter are used to give commands to the OS. There are multiple command interpreters known as the shells in Unix and Linux systems. There are several different shells like the bourne shell, C shell, bourne again shell, corn shell and etc. The main function of the command interpreter is to get and execute the user specified command. Many of the commands manipulate files, create, delete, list, print, copy, execute and so on. The commands can be implemented in two general ways. The command interpreter itself contains the code to execute the command. For example, a command to delete a file may cause the command interpreter to jump to a particular section of its code that sets up the parameters and make the appropriate system call. The code to implement the command is in a function in a separate file. The interpreter searches for the file and loads it into the memory and executes it by passing the parameter. Thus, by adding a new functions, new commands can be added easily to the interpreter without disturbing it. Graphical user interface. A second strategy for interfacing with the operating system is through a user-friendly graphical user interface or GUI. Rather than having users directly enter commands via a command line interface, a GUI allows provides a mouse-based window and menu system as an interface. GUI provides a desktop metaphor where the mouse is moved to position its pointer on the images or icons on the screen or desktop that represent programs, files, directories, and system functions. Depending on the mouse pointer's location, clicking a button on the mouse can invoke a program, select a file or directory known as folder, or pull down a menu that contains commands. Now let us see the system calls. What are system calls? Briefly point out its types. System calls is a means to access the services of the operating system, generally written in C or C++, although some are written in assembly for optimal performance. The below figure illustrates the sequence of system calls required to copy a file content from one file input file to another file output file. An example to illustrate how the system calls are used: writing a simple program to read data from one file and copy them to another file. There are a number of system calls used to finish this task. The first system call is to write a message on the screen monitor, then to accept the input file name. Then another system call is to write a message on the screen, then to accept the output file name. When the program tries to open the input file, it may find that there is no file of that name or that the file is protected against access. In these cases, the program should print a message on the console, another system call, and then terminate abnormally another system call and create a new one, another system call. Now that both the files are opened, we enter a loop that reads from the input file another system call and writes to output file another system call. Finally, after the entire file is copied, the program may close both files, another system call, write a message to the console or Windows system call, and finally terminate normally file system call. See the figure. Most programmers do not use the low-level system calls directly, but instead use an application programming interface API instead of direct system calls. Provides for general program probability between different systems. The API then makes the appropriate system calls through the system call interface. Using a system call table to assess specific numbered system calls, each system call has a specific numbered system call. The system call table consisting of system call number and address of the particular service invokes a particular service routine for a specific system call. The caller need know nothing about how the system call is implemented or what it does during execution. Three general methods used to pass parameters to OS are to pass parameters in registers. If the parameters are large blocks, address of block where parameters are stored in memory is sent to OS in the register Linux and Solaris. Parameters can be pushed onto the stack by program and popped off the stack by OS. Types of system calls. The system calls can be categorized into six major categories: process control, file management, device management, information management, communications, protection. Process control. See the figure. Process control: end, abort, load, execute, create, process, terminate, process, get, process attributes, set, process attributes, wait for time, wait, event, signal, event, allocate, and free memory. File management, create file, delete file, open, close, read, write, reposition, get file attributes, set file attributes, device management, request device, release device, read, write, reposition, get device attributes, set device attributes, logically attach or detach devices. Information maintenance: get time or date, set time or date, get system data, set system data, get process file or device attributes, set process file or device attributes. Communications: create, delete communication, connection, send, receive messages, transfer status information, attach or detach remote devices. Now let us see process control. Process control system calls include end, abort, load, execute, create, process, terminate, process, get, set, process attributes, wait for timer, event, signal, event, and allocate and free memory. Processes must be created, launched, monitored, passed, resumed, and eventually stopped. When one process passes or stops, then another must be launched or resumed. Process attributes like process priority, max, allowable, execution time, etc. are set and retrieved by OS. After creating the new process, the parent process may have to wait time or wait for a event to occur. Wait event, the process sends back a signal when the event has occurred. Signal event. In DOS, the command interpreter loaded first, then loads the process and transfers control to it. The interpreter does not resume until the process has completed, as shown in the figure. See the figure. Because the Unix is a multitasking system, the command interpreter remains completely resident when executing a process, as shown in the figure below. The user can switch back to the command interpreter at any time and can place the running process in the background even if it was not originally launched as a background process. In order to do this, the command interpreter first executes a fork system call, which creates a second process, which is an exact duplicate clone of the original command interpreter. The original process is known as the parent, and the cloned process is known as the child. With its own unique process ID and parent ID, the child process then executes an exec system call, which replaces its code with that of the desired process. The parent command interpreter normally waits for the child to complete before issuing a new command prompt, but in some cases it can also issue a new prompt right away without waiting for the child process to complete. The child is then said to be running in the background or as a background process. Now let us see file management. The file management functions of OS or file management system calls include create file, delete file, open, close, read, write, reposition, get file attributes, and set file attributes. After creating a file, the file is opened, data is read or written to a file. The file pointer may need to be repositioned to a point. The file attributes like file name, file type, permissions, etc. are set and retrieved using system calls. These operations may also be supported for directories as well as ordinary files. Now let us see device management. Device management system calls include request device, release device, read, write, reposition, get or set device attributes, and logically attach or detach devices. When a process needs a resource, a request for the resource is done, then the control is granted to the process if requested resources is already attached to some other process. The requesting process has to wait. In multiprogramming systems, after a process uses the device, it has to be returned to OS so that another process can use the device. Devices may be physical, example disk drivers, or virtual or abstract, example files, partitions, and RAM disks. Now let us see information maintenance. Information maintenance system calls include calls to get or set the time, date, system data, and process file or device attributes. These system calls can use to transfer the information between user and the OS. Information like current time or date, number of current users, version number of OS, amount of free memory, disk space, etc. are passed from OS to the user. Now let us see communication. Communication system calls create or delete communication connections, send or receive messages, transfer status information, attach, detach remote devices. The message passing model must support calls to identify a remote process and or host with which to communicate, establish a connection between the two processes, open and close the connection as needed, transmit messages along the connection, wait for incoming messages in either a blocking or non-blocking state, delete the connection when no longer needed. The shared memory model must support calls to create and access memory that is shared amongst processes and threads, free up shared memory and or dynamically allocate it as needed. Message passing is simpler and easier, particularly for inter-computer communications, and is generally appropriate for small amounts of data. It is easy to implement, but there are system calls for each read and write process. Shared memory is faster and is generally the better approach where large amount of data are to be shared. This model is difficult to implement and it consists of only few system calls. Now let us see protection. Protection provides a mechanism for controlling which users or processors have access to which system resources. System calls allow the access mechanisms to be adjusted as needed and for non-privileged users to be granted evaluated access permissions used access permissions under carefully controlled temporary circumstances. Now let us see system programs. List and explain the different categories of system programs. A collection of programs that provide a convenient environment for program development and execution other than OS are called system programs or system utilities. System programs may be divided into five categories: file management programs to delete, create, copy, rename, print, list, and generally manipulate files and directories, status information. Utilities to check on date, time, number of users, process running, data logging, etc. System registers are used to store and recall configuration information for the particular applications. File modification, example, text editors and other tools which can change file content. Programming language support, example, compiler, linker, debugger, profilers, assemblers, library, archive management, and interpreters for common language and support for make. Program loading and execution. Loaders, dynamic loaders, overlay loaders, etc., as well as interactive debuggers. Communications. Programs for providing connectivity between processes and users, including mail, web browsers, remote logins, file transfers, and remote command execution. Now let us see operating system design and implementation. Design goals. The first problem in designing a system is to define goals and specification at the highest level. The design of the system will be affected by the choice of the hardware and the type of the system: batch, time shared, single user, multi user, distributed, real time, or general purpose. Beyond this highest level, design level, the requirements may be much harder to specify. The requirements can, however, be divided into two basic groups: user goals and system goals. User requirements, system requirements. User requirements are the features that users care about and understand, like system should be convenient to use, easy to learn, reliable, safe, and fast. System requirements are written for the developers, that is, people who design the OS. Their requirements are like easy to design, implement, and maintain, flexible, reliable, error-free, and efficient. Mechanism and policies. Policies determine what is to be done. Mechanisms determine how it is to be implemented. Example, in timer, counter, and decrementing counter is the mechanism and deciding how long the time has to be set in set is the policies. Policies change over time. In the worst case, each change in the policy would require a change in the underlying mechanism. If properly separated and implemented, policy changes can be easily adjusted without rewriting the code. Just by adjusting parameters or possibly loading new data or configuration files. Now let us see implementation. Traditionally, OS were written in assembly language. In recent years, OS are written in C++. Critical sections of code are still written in assembly language. The first OS that was not written in assembly language was the Master Control Program, MCP. The advantage of using a higher level language for implementing operating system are the code can be written faster, more compact, easy to port to other systems, that is easier to understand and debug. The only disadvantages of the implementing an operating system is higher level language are reduced speed and increased storage requirements.